Mark Metrick, Saks Fifth Avenue president and CEO. Mark, what are you expecting this holiday season? Help us understand what's going on.
Well, Leslie, I have to tell you that Matt Shea and the guys at the NRF are geniuses. We are cautiously optimistic about the holiday. We're feeling, and if you read and think about how they're approaching it, it's about the shift from experiential into products and goods. And I feel good. I think the consumer's ready. They want to splurge. They want to indulge. They want some escapism. It's the holidays. So it's cautious optimism, but it's certainly optimism.
Now, how will they be splurging? Do you expect them to be splurging in your stores? Do you expect them to be splurging mostly online? And how do you kind of translate that holiday season experience online when people are so used to, you know, going to the mall with their family and doing the whole Black Friday thing and looking at the windows, which Saks is so well known for, and the holiday music and all of that? How do you translate that into an online experience?
Yeah, sure. I mean, first, you know, look, we still believe in our stores, and we've believed in our stores through this crisis. Honestly, since what we've called the reentry period at Saks, our stores have been performing about flat to last year on a rolling basis since opening. So we haven't seen some dramatic fall off there. Traffic's been down, but the conversions are way up. And online is something that's over-indexed and has been and was supposed to be even absent the pandemic. So, we've been working at Saks even before this about ways to translate the theater of what the store is into this next normal. An example of that is tonight we are unveiling our holiday windows and light show on Fifth Avenue, and we're doing it live streamed over Saks.com. That used to be crowds of people in the streets, shoulder to shoulder. And that's just not how we do it in 2020, right? So it's all about making this pivot right now.
And Mark, what about consumer spend overall? Clearly, there hasn't been a second big bout of stimulus, and some are concerned that will impact spending. On the flip side, does just consumer confidence stemming from good news about vaccines offset that?
Yeah, I think, you know, in the luxury space, we have the market, which, you know, you could see, obviously, and you guys are talking a lot about it today, even lots of promise there. That's a big driver also, the confidence that's coming around. And I do believe that consumer spending, it's a pie. And I think that pie is shifting. And you saw what's happening in gaming in Nevada and what's going on there. So it's travel, leisure, other things that are turning into retail sales for us. So, it's a pie. Right now, I worry about getting as much of that as I can.
Mark, what's your strategic plan as municipalities start to enforce greater restrictions as cases rise and they're trying to prevent, you know, hospitals from getting overwhelmed and so forth? Do you plan to stay open? What types of strategic measures are you taking to ensure that your consumers and your employees are safe?
Look, we constructed a rubric, you know, right out of the chute in March. And it's really a decision, you know, tree that goes through. It's four key drivers. Obviously, it's government and health experts and what they're saying. It's really about, you know, the health and safety of our people, our customers, both internal and external. The economics of being open. I mean, you could be open even if you don't have to close and nobody comes. So why be open? And then, of course, it's the local community. And how do they feel about it? Look, the bottom line is we closed our New York flagship. Actually, prior to any shelter-in-place order that came or mandatory close, we were the first big store in New York City to do so. So we really are putting our consumer and our, you know, and that's both our internal, our associates, and our consumers first.
Mark, are there any particular products that you're putting right at the front of the store or right at the top of the website because of all the events of 2020 that you think could be top sellers in the holiday season that maybe never in the past would have been considered a holiday item?
Look, you know, masks, for example, that's like the new iPhone cover. I mean, everyone's going to have one. But as far as front and forward, you know, Saks is in the fashion business, and we're going to have what's in fashion, and some of it fits right in with what's going on. And you think about things like Luxe Lounge. I mean, that's going to be more comfortable dressing. That'll be, you know, much more pronounced gift giving. Again, masks or house shoes. I mean, who would have thought slippers and more casual footwear was going to be something big? So these are the holiday trends that we're seeing. But again, I think people are getting ready and they want to buy. They're right now, they're buying footwear. They're buying handbags. They're buying accessories for themselves. Men are buying everything. So, you know, it's just an exciting time. And being in the fashion business right now means you got to meet the customer where they want to be.
Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.